In the previous few units, we learned to import an OHLC time series stock data as a data frame. In the upcoming few units, we will learn how to plot the financial markets data for better visualization and understanding. To begin, let us first prepare the data that we want to visualize. We have saved the data of an Indian stock named Infosys on the local machine in a CSV file named as infy_dv.csv. Using Pandas, we will import this data in the Python namespace by calling the function pd.read_csv and convert it into a data frame named as infy. You can see the data uploaded to our working environment. Next, we will plot the Infosys close price data against time. Now, we have only two columns in the data set which we need to plot. We use the matplotlib package to plot. To get started with matplotlib, we will first import the package. It is a common practice to import matplotlib.pyplot using the alias plt. If at all you are working on an IPython notebook, %matplotlib inline becomes important, as it makes sure that the graphs or plots are embedded inside the notebook. Next, we will use the plot function to plot these data points and the show function to visualize these data points. You can see the output here. We can see that a line graph is plotted by default. There are two axes here, a vertical axis, or the y-axis, and a horizontal axis, or the x-axis. The y-axis represents the close price of the Infy series, and the x-axis represents the dates. You can see a sharp drop in prices from 1185 to almost 1145. However, it is quite difficult to read the dates here. So, let us tweak this code a bit and make the plot visually appealing and understandable. The output for this is as follows. Let us understand the code line by line. plt.figure, fig size equals 14,5, customizes the size of the plot as per the inputs. Here, 14,5 represents the breadth and length of the plot. plt.plot, infy_close, b, helps in plotting the blue color of the infy_close series line graph. plt.plot, infy_close, ro, helps in plotting the discrete red data points of the closing prices of the infy_close series. Here, R stands for red, and O stands for circles, while plotting are discrete data points. That is why the points are colored red, while the line graph color is blue. plt.gridTrue gives a grid layout to the plot. plt.title, Infosys close price representation, gives the title to the plot. plt.xlabel, trading days, labels the x-axis, as shown in the figure. plt.ylabel, Infosys close price, labels the y-axis, as shown in the figure. And that's how we plot a simple two-dimensional graph using matplotlib. You can do a lot more, like 3D plotting, using the pyplot module of the matplotlib package. In the upcoming IPython notebook, we will look to explore this further.